In this video, we're going to talk about the role of sodium and chloride in plant culture. Now, typically, sodium and chloride we view as being undesirable elements, but believe it or not, they do actually have a function in the plant. The function of sodium, as an example, is it's not considered actually an essential element, so if it actually is not there, the plant will not suffer. But if it is present, it will actually help out with some metabolism functions within the cell, the synthesis of chlorophyll, which is the green pigment in the plant leaves. It can also serve as a partial replacement for potassium if there happens to be a deficiency, and which helps to regulate stomatal opening. And stomates are basically the little pores in the bottom of the leaves. Now, chloride, on the other hand, basically its function, it is considered an essential element. So without it, plants can actually suffer. So as an example, chloride helps out with plant metabolism functions within the cell. It also contributes to the photosynthetic process and also helps out with osmosis, which is the movement of water in and out of the cells, which helps regulate ionic balance within the plant. When it comes to the deficiency symptoms of sodium and chloride, since sodium itself is not actually an essential element, it doesn't exhibit any deficiency symptoms that we're aware of. Chloride, on the other hand, because it is essential, can show some symptoms. Typically what happens is on the older leaves of the plant, you might get some yellow blotches that form between the veins. The veins of the plant still stay green, and within those yellow blotches, sometimes you get these dark kind of, necrotic spots, which is basically dead leaf tissue. Now, deficiency of chloride should not be confused with deficiency of magnesium, which both occur on older leaves and show kind of yellowing between the veins. So you might want to have your growing media and your tissue tested to verify that. But going back to the deficiency, if you do see that occur, basically with sodium deficiency, there's no reason to correct it because it doesn't exist. So again, there's no reason to do that. For chloride, on the other hand, if there is a deficiency, you can use things such as calcium chloride, maybe potassium chloride, ammonium chloride. Those types of fertilizers can be used to supplement. And it is suggested that you should have at least 2 parts per million chloride found in either your growing media or your water at all times to make sure deficiency symptoms don't appear. As far as sodium and chloride toxicity are concerned, they basically kind of have similar looking symptoms. Both express symptoms where the leaf tips of the older leaves will turn brown, kind of crispy necrotic tissue, or the leaf margins will do that as well, or it could be both. However, with chloride toxicity, what we see is we also can get some premature yellowing of the leaf edges, and that yellowing can therefore progress into the brown tissue. Sometimes with chloride toxicity, we also see overall wilting of the plant, which doesn't make sense because there's plenty of water. But again, it looks similar to other types of, such as potassium deficiency or micronutrient toxicities. So you want to test the growing media and specifically the tissue to verify whether or not that's happening. Now, if you do see a sodium and or chloride toxicity occurring, the first place to look is at your water. Typically, you want about 50 parts per million sodium, 70 parts per million chloride maximum, as we mentioned. But if you start seeing rates up around 100 to 200 parts per million in the water, that right there can be contributing to the toxicity symptoms that you're seeing. If the levels are high in the water, you may want to consider leaching, which is simply running water through and flushing out the salts out through the bottom of the container, possibly looking at diluting the water with different water source that's low in those elements. Or at worst case scenario, if you have real high levels of these elements, look at using reverse osmosis to kind of strip those out of the water. And I'd like to thank you for listening to this presentation. Have a nice day.
For more information, visit our website, follow us on social media.